card number three in the 12 cards of Christmas. So, let me tell you the first few things right off the bat. I'm working with a card base that is 4 1/4 by 11, scored at 5 1/2. It's a top fold card. For the inside, I have two mats. One is 4 by 5 1/4, and then the other is 3 3/4 by 5. I'm not going to do any stamping because I have stamped out a whole bunch of sentiments and made them like sentiment embellishments, kind of like this little guy is. I have this whole bag is completely full when I put those back there, back in it. So, I'm trying to use some of those guys. I'm going to go ahead and stick these two down because this is the sentiment I'm using on the inside of this one. And that one came from, I believe, a Stampendous stamp set. Let's see. Yes, it's one that has a truck and a Christmas tree and some presents, and it has the die cuts for each of those. Which I need to use that this year. And I will be doing that. I just wanted to get some easy ones out the way right at the beginning. That my memory card adapter goes in, and it's driving me crazy. I don't know where it went. You ever do that? Lay something down and it drives you nuts because you don't know where you laid it down at? I'm bad about that. I'm just going to glue this down with some wet glue, and I'm using my art glitter glue. I get it from maymaymadeit.com. As I'm filming this, it is October the 13th. If you live in an area that gets below 40 degrees at night, they won't ship it to you until it's over 40 degrees at night. I have some scraps here that I wanted to put to use, so I figured what better time than now? We'll put them on the front of this card. So I just pulled out a piece of white cardstock, and it's just a bit smaller than my front. With this white paper, since I know it's the front size of the front of my card, it should be just shy of 4 1/4. Let's get my ruler. It is... yeah, just barely shy, 1/16 of an inch shy of 4 1/4. And the same with the half, 5 1/2. It's just 1/16 of an inch smaller all the way around. So, I'm going to go ahead and stick these guys on here. And I think I'll start with this red one. I have two of each of these, I thought. Yeah. They're going to be a little too long, and that's okay. I could put these directly on my card front, but I like the thickness that adding this extra layer provides. I like that thickness, so that's why I do it this way. I didn't do a very good job of putting my ATG down here. I say use whatever adhesive you like, you know. And like I said, these are too long, but that's okay. I want to leave a little bit of a white edge on the side. Not at the top or the bottom, just at the side. Why? I don't know. Because that's just what I decided I wanted. to green. Hopefully be a little more careful with what I'm doing here. And I'm going to overlay these just a little bit. Just a tiny bit. Then I'm going to switch to the other side. And I'm going to do the red on that side. Because I think I'm only going to need one of the polka dot one in right in the middle. My goodness. I am making a mess. Gonna need the one right in the middle. And then I'm just gonna cut off this excess. That works. That. And then I have this sentiment here that I've already obviously stamped, stuck down, and matted a bunch of times. I matted it twice, just a little bit bigger than what it was. I did it on craft and then on red, and then on paper from this same paper pad here, I did a rectangle, and then I did another rectangle under that. Then I put a brad in it, and then I matted it on white. And now I'm going to pop it up on foam. Let's see. That straight? Not bad. And then I'm going to take my Wink Estella, and on these polka dots, I'm just going to give a few of them a little bit of a shimmer. There. That kind of balances out that green there, too. So that's it. Let me know what you think. I hope you guys have a great day and a glorious tomorrow. Bye, guys.